What's going on, everybody? This is DK Dynamite, and tonight we're going to be talking about the first major update in Call of Duty Vanguard, some huge announcements by Sledgehammer, a secret unlock, and even a possible teaser for the upcoming Zombies experience. Definitely stay tuned. But before we jump into that, be sure to hit that subscribe button down below, and don't forget, I'll be playing with every single one of you that sends me proof of using code Dynamite over at checkout on GamerAdvantage.com. Really means a lot to me, and I also want to hear your thoughts in the comments about how much you're enjoying the current multiplayer alpha. People do have to remember that the alpha is such a limited version of the game itself and purely exists just to get our feedback so that the beta and launch window can be as smooth as possible. It's hilarious that some people out there are purposely attempting to use the alpha to review the entirety of an unreleased game. It just doesn't make sense to me at all. But before we continue on with Call of Duty Vanguard, let's go ahead and thank the sponsor of tonight's video. Now, tonight's video has been sponsored by 1v1me. It's an app that's currently available on iOS devices in the US, allowing you to make money facing other players in Call of Duty. I mean, who doesn't want to make some money for playing multiplayer, right? It's super simple and totally free to play. Just start a challenge, set your rules and the wager amount, then wait for somebody to accept it. The app does require you to stream on Twitch in order to play, so it's able to verify the authenticity of the game itself, so you'll be safe from scammers and cheaters. They just launched team play and free-for-all mode, so if you got a squad you'd like to grind with, they can get in on the action too. I've always loved friendly competition with wager matches, and this app really ensures that nothing could go wrong with money on the line. This also reminds me of the wager matches back in Black Ops 1 over 10 years ago, which I used to grind daily. I was a big fan of those. Now, you do have to be 18 years or older in order to play for money, but anybody can still play $0 wagers and start to build a reputation on the app itself. Definitely worth getting into some practice before you start betting. But if you're lucky enough to be one of the first 1,000 people to download the app from my exclusive link in this video's description, then you'll get $1 for free to begin playing with. So if you're ready to jump into the action, be sure to download it using the link 1v1.me/DKDynamite and add me on the app at DKDynamite1. Good luck and thank you to 1v1me for sponsoring tonight's video. Now back to the video, my quick review of the alpha thus far is that it feels like I'm playing World War II on Modern Warfare's engine, but with Cold War visibility. The movement feels fine to me, but will probably be tweaked out a little bit by the time the beta rolls around in a few weeks. The time to kill does feel like it's right in between Modern Warfare 2019 and Cold War, which, if I'm not mistaken, people were asking for anyway, so I'm not sure why I'm seeing complaints about that over on Twitter and Reddit. The map design also feels fun so far, while the destructible environments have me wondering how that'll affect 6v6 and then the future zombies mode later down the line. Lots of potential with that, and it reminds me of how interactive the environments were back in Call of Duty Ghost. Now, despite Modern Warfare 2019 not being my cup of tea, I think a similar feeling game with a different approach to the map design, gunplay, and mechanics can be executed flawlessly by the right studio that doesn't just focus on casual players, but everybody that's enjoying the game, whether you've been playing for the past decade or whether or not you're first jumping into COD multiplayer for the first time. My only problems with Vanguard thus far, with an alpha of course, is including the map spawns, since I've seen enemies spawn right behind me for whatever reason. Visibility when hurt specifically, since it's a bit obnoxious right now and kind of takes up your entire screen, gets a bit difficult to recover from that. Wallbanging is hilariously broken, since your aim assist will track enemies through walls, while the bullet penetration also feels a bit unfair right now. And I think incendiary rounds need a bit of a nerf, since people love camping with that bar. I've seen it quite a few times while streaming and even off stream. But that's what an alpha is for, right? Imagine if the full game released like this in this specific state without an alpha or a beta to highlight these issues so the Sledgehammer can iron them out before the full game drops on November the 5th. That's the point of this, right? People out there seem to think that this is like a little bit of the final version of the game, but it's not at all. It's just a small portion of an older version of the game. And lucky for us, Sledgehammer has already confirmed today what will be included in their first list of changes to Vanguard multiplayer. This list includes visibility when damaged, spawn tuning, map visibility, audio mix tuning, which I'm assuming is referring to footsteps, since people out there on Twitter have said that the footstep audio is a bit too low for a few people's liking, and nameplate visibility issues, since I'm sure you guys have seen, you can see people's nameplates through walls, which is a bit unfair, and they've also mentioned to tag them on Twitter as Sledgehammer Games with any positive and respectful criticism you guys have of the game itself. It's all about being constructive, right? If you already have an agenda against COD, or you already chose Battlefield and Halo over Vanguard, then don't say anything at all if it's gonna be disrespectful towards the devs that put in their blood, sweat, and tears to pumping this game out. It doesn't make any sense, it doesn't help the longevity of Vanguard whatsoever, but if you're liking what you see so far, then put out a tweet later tonight talking about what you like about the game, what you don't like, and Sledgehammer will for sure listen to that feedback and make sure the game is as solid as it can be by the time the beta rolls around and then the full launch in just over 2 months from now. But I'm currently level 18 in the alpha, and I'm sure ranks are going to be reset by the time the beta comes out in a couple of weeks. Because it would be unfair, right, if Xbox and PC start at level 1 and then PlayStation players are already rank 30 or higher. That would be ridiculous and obviously a bit unfair for those players out there who want to get access to all the attachments, perks, killstreaks that you can unlock by just ranking up. They also added in trios today, which is great since yesterday it was absent from the full launch of the alpha itself, and that's fine, right? I like when they sporadically release content throughout an alpha or beta, not just dropping their entire load in one day. Just make the weekend a bit more replayable by adding in different things each day. I mean, that to me is totally fine. We got a bit of a steady start yesterday with just 2v2, and now we have an extra squad mate to grind with as of today. Let me know how you're enjoying that down below in the comments. Now, people out there have reported that they are unlocking secret attachments and perks already just by playing the alpha. So I'll put some images on screen thanks to Prestigious Key. People have already unlocked some different red dot sights for certain weapons, and I've seen some controversy around this, right? I know there weren't too many red dot sights back during the Second World War, but it's Call of Duty, right? It's a game. Relax. Not going to be 100% one-to-one realistic from what World War II was actually like, and they have to make sure that gameplay is prioritized over accurate storytelling. It's a game. That's what it's for. And people out there have also saw the Tactician perk being unlocked, which is already in Call of Duty Mobile, allowing you to hold multiple TAC grenades at a time. You can already hold multiple lethal grenades at a time in Vanguard right now, so I'm not surprised that this is also going to be a perk by the time the game fully releases. And people also unlocked the spy plane at level 17. We can already use a spy plane by using the buy station in one of the buy rounds, so I think that's just an example of how late we're going to have to unlock the spy plane at during the full release of multiplayer itself. So let me know about other secrets you guys may have found in Vanguard thus far. Drop some comments down below or tag me on Twitter. People have also found what apparently is going to be the mastery camo in Vanguard multiplayer at launch. Now, I'm going to put out a disclaimer right now that this is probably not going to be the final mastery camo. It may be a camo in the game at launch, or right now it's just a placeholder for what eventually will be the mastery camo. People have seen references to a chrome camo, which wasn't very favorable back during World War II, but it's been 4 years since their last Call of Duty, so I'm sure in the meantime, they've heard our feedback about that camo and will likely end up incorporating something as spicy as Dark Matter, Obsidian, Damascus, something that's been favorited a lot more by the hardcore Call of Duty community. But it's an alpha, right? We're bound to see things that are left over from their last Call of Duty, bound to see things that are in Black Ops Cold War, Modern Warfare 2019. I mean, that's the way alphas work, right? That's what the game is for, to test things out, or the game in its current state, I should say. So with that being said, definitely hold your horses. I'm almost certain that this won't be the final mastery camo of Vanguard multiplayer, but if it is, then I'm sure the community is not going to be happy about that on November the 5th. But you guys know the internet is a crazy place, and somebody out there has already somehow posted images of what the creative class menu is going to look like in Vanguard multiplayer, and the images are some that I can't show on screen for obvious reasons. Maybe check the description down below, but the images do showcase 10 default attachments: reticles, charms, stickers, a PKM placeholder for the DP27 LMG. The PKM was, of course, in Modern Warfare multiplayer. So these images, again, may not reflect the final version of the creative class menu for Vanguard, but is what we're working with thus far. So if you guys are interested in that, maybe check the description down below. But with that being said, a 10 attachment system does sound interesting, and I honestly feel like whatever Modern Warfare and Black Ops Cold War introduced us to in terms of multiplayer mechanics and features, that's probably going to be somewhere around the norm that we're going to be seeing in all upcoming Call of Duty multiplayers going forward, based on how successful the past two Call of Duties have been, right? Whether you like Modern Warfare or Cold War more than one another, those two games introduce features that are probably going to be here to stay. But yesterday, somebody accomplished the impossible, or what I thought was impossible, at least in 2v2 Champion Hill. I figured this would only be obtainable through 3v3, and that is the V2 rocket for $25,000. Based on that number alone, I'm going to assume right now that it'll require 25 kills in regular 6v6 modes of Vanguard, but I thought this wouldn't be obtainable at all, and somehow they pulled this off. I'm assuming what they probably did is save as many lives as possible, probably grab the free life token that they already had 12 lives on them to gain an extra 1,000 points. If only you could share money with your friends, then this could be obtainable a lot sooner. But right before their final match of the bracket, they call this bad boy in, and he reuses the same animations and HUD pop-up as World War II's V2 rocket that'll probably be polished by the time the game fully comes out. But it'll then wipe any enemies that are left, and before even playing your final match of the bracket, it'll just allow you to have a victory during the buy round. It's hilarious. So you know, this is almost an impossible task, and it's probably harder to buy this in Champion Hill than it is to just unlock it in regular 6v6. I'm sure people out there will understand that more in due time, but I'm still happy to see the return of the V2 rocket nonetheless. It's gonna be fun to go for when regular multiplayer does release, and I'm sure somebody out there will end up unlocking this pretty quickly when the beta goes live in just around 2 weeks' time. But altogether, killstreaks are very fun in Champion Hill. Let me know how you're liking them down below in the comments. I know some of the higher streaks are a bit unfair to go up against. There's almost no counter going up against a death machine or a flamethrower. They're just too overpowered with those killstreaks, and I'm sure nerfs will happen so that maybe when the beta rolls around, killstreaks will feel a little bit more balanced. Maybe they'll reduce how much fire you have in that flamethrower. Maybe you'll run out of ammo at some point. Maybe they'll reduce the health of the suit that you're wearing with that. Maybe reduce some of the ammo and death machine. I'm not sure how they can fix that exactly, but Sledgehammer will end up finding a way without a doubt, because right now, if you go up against those bad boys, you're done. Like, there is no way to counter that unless the people that are using the streaks are potatoes and they miss their shots, then it's tough. But you guys probably all saw the return of finishing moves in Champion Hill, which I'm happy to see because, like I said earlier, Modern Warfare 2019 and Cold War have set the precedent for how they're going to release cosmetics in pretty much all future Call of Duties, with finishing moves in the bundles, gestures, pets, mastercrafts, reactives, the list goes on, but you see what I mean, right? We're going to be seeing the return of those features in likely every Call of Duty to release in the foreseeable future. But next up, something really spicy that popped up in some people's alpha downloads is as follows, right? This apparent zombies type of bundle, which has the following: beat back the hordes with Roland reactive bundle. Note, this bundle includes a blueprint and a watermelon. Watermelon is not edible. So at first I'm like, wait, is this a placeholder for something random? But then there was a timer on screen saying that it expires in about a day. So I'm not sure if maybe by the end of this weekend during the alpha they release type of bundle that I guess we can use in Cold War and Warzone. I'm not sure what this exactly means, but it also feels silly to think about them selling bundles in the item shop during an alpha or beta period. Maybe it could also be a free bundle they release for those out there that participated in the PlayStation exclusive alpha this weekend. Lots of possibilities here, but it says beat back the hordes. So is this zombies related? Will they end up releasing this right around the time they end up marketing Call of Duty Vanguard Zombies, which is said to be at some point during the Hallows Eve event, which is probably at some point late season 6 of Black Ops Cold War. Now, it also says the watermelon is an edible. So is this a melee weapon, a finishing move, a gesture? I'm really confused on what that could be, but I have seen discussions lately about a potential zombies beta, and my thoughts on this haven't really changed since we first talked about this last summer. So first and foremost, what is Treyarch up to right now, right? They're going to be leading Vanguard Zombies this year, but right now they're potentially working on a main quest 3 for Outbreak. It's, again, a little unlikely, but it's still possible. They're 100% working on DLC 4, the final round-based map of Cold War Zombies. Then right after that, jumping right into development on Vanguard Zombies for potential marketing in late October. So is there really time for a beta at all in Vanguard? I don't really see that happening, but at most, here's what I said last summer about potential zombies beta. If there ever is one in a future Call of Duty, it wouldn't be a portion of a round-based map or even a room of one. It would have to be an LTM of sorts like Onslaught. That to me makes the most sense and probably doesn't take that long to polish. If they released, let's say, a Cold War Zombies beta last summer, then it probably would have been being able to play Onslaught on a map like Miami or a map like Cartel. Something along those lines where it gives you a feel for zombies in that game with that engine, with those mechanics, with that gunplay, but not something like a round-based map where you're essentially spoiling what could be a phenomenal experience at release. You know, why spoil that so early? Zombies makes more sense to just be experienced for the first time during launch week. But you can also say the closest we'll end up getting to a Vanguard Zombies alpha is the zombies event we already saw in Verdansk not too long ago, the Outbreak, where you're able to face off against some zombies over at the shipwreck location, and later on, other locations around the map. That was zombies on the Modern Warfare engine, which is what Vanguard Zombies is going to feel like in a couple of weeks' time. But last and definitely not least, headquarters. So we don't know much about that feature if it's going to release in Vanguard right now, but as I talked about in a video a little while ago, it would be a big missed opportunity not to see that in Vanguard considering next-gen capabilities. We have new consoles now. I mean, they're on the Modern Warfare engine, so we could have seamless transitions from one screen to another, going from your lobby to the headquarters, loading in bigger environments a lot faster. A lot of potential with that, and I'd be shocked if they don't end up incorporating that this year, but if they are gonna do it, I'm assuming we'll get some full-fledged marketing for that, as well as its own trailer, in a couple of weeks, if not over a month from now. But looking at the environment we have in Champion Hill, this is already a space that's similar to headquarters, so why not put a headquarters feature like that in a space like this, even reuse the space if they have to. I wouldn't mind seeing headquarters in an area that looks like Champion Hill, or in an area that looks exactly like the buy station area right in the center. Let me know your feeling about headquarters down below in the comments, and whether or not you used the feature a lot back during World War II. But that is about it. This has been DK Dynamite. Leave our thoughts down below in the comments section. Don't forget not to delete the Alpha application once you're done with the Alpha this weekend on PlayStation. It'll be the same application we're going to end up using for the Beta, which launches in about 2 weeks from now. Unlike previous years, where the Alpha for Modern Warfare and Cold War were separate apps from the Beta, let me know how you're feeling down below in the comments about the first major updates and patch notes for Vanguard Multiplayer. What are your thoughts on the secret unlocks? And also, if whether or not that bundle's referencing zombies in any way, shape, or form. Really hope you've enjoyed, and peace out, everyone.